The setup that was the NFL draft quickly coming down right now outside First Energy Stadium.
The North Coast Harbor area was seen by tens of millions worldwide. But now what's become of that site?
News 5's John Kosick is with us live right now. John, city leaders ready to move forward now with plans for that site?
Yeah, they're ready to continue the momentum that started up on Public Square and flows through the malls over the convention center and continue it down to the lakefront. But to be clear, this will not happen overnight.
The NFL draft showcased downtown Cleveland and the lakefront to the world while opening up eyes to the potential of the site, which has long been talked about for future development. In fact, on the Cleveland Planning Commission's website, you will still find the Cleveland Lakefront Development Plan and its promise of a mixed-use neighborhood north of First Energy Stadium. Yes, the link is still active, but the project, which looked to break ground in 2015, clearly is not. The city parting ways with the developer last year with an eye towards the bigger picture.
We need to not look at this as a site. We need to look at this as an opportunity and not just a site parcel by parcel development.
That will likely entail years of planning and input. What the city is moving forward with now is the concept of a land bridge, applying to ODOT recently for $6.5 million to get the process started, offering this rendering of the location they're looking at from Mall C over the railroad tracks and Shoreway to the lakefront. It is the same area that was home to a similar bridge during the 1936 Great Lakes Exposition. The price tag, an estimated $229 million.
The land bridge is going to be challenging, but it's something that it's definitely doable. We saw what we could do in one weekend, but what if we had that all the time? What if we had constant access to the lakefront?
A project that will be shovel-ready shortly is the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame's new transformative expansion stretching west along the waterfront.
We're working on concepts and renderings, and soon we'll be able to share some of them. And we'll have community listening sessions and make sure that we're going in the right direction with this. But our ultimate goal is to lock the design by year end and start groundbreaking next spring after the snow melts.
It is a project that, like the NFL draft, will be focused on bringing life to the harbor.
Our expansion is going to activate the lakefront even more. We're building at the lakefront. We're going to have activity on our music plaza in front of the museum. And what we're building things that aren't just for museum visitors. They're for community access and community activity.
And that Rock Hall work scheduled to be underway a year from now. The city is hoping to learn from the state about those initial funds for the land bridge sometime in June. Live at Shaker Heights, John Kosick, News 5.
Thank you, John. Such an opportunity. I can't wait to see what they do down there. That's fantastic.